demo that we're getting ready to do with Patty Page from Baked Ideas. She is amazing at decorating cookies. And so as you might have known if you stopped by earlier, we have partnered up with Vitamix at Food Loves Tech, and we're doing something really fun in this session. We're actually showing the new adapters with the Vitamix. Everybody's, if you have a Vitamix or a blender, you've probably seen this size. Now Vitamix has two smaller sizes. This one, which is a personal cup adapter, and this one, which is for like grinding different spices and herbs. So one thing that I know that is important to me is using all natural dyes in cookies and cake icing. So instead of using food coloring, today what we've done is we've taken freeze-dried blueberries and freeze-dried raspberries, and we've ground them to a powder in this little adapter on the Vitamix. So I'm just gonna blend this one up. What's really cool about these adapters is that the Vitamix knows that it's a smaller size cup on the machine, and so it's not gonna put it on a setting that's too high for this particular cup size. So now that that's ground into a powder, we can use it to color our different kind of royal icing for these cookie demos. And so we've got Patty here from Baked Ideas. Definitely check out her Instagram at Baked Ideas. Beautiful cookies. You guys are gonna get to sample some in a few minutes. And definitely feel free to take some photos of these cookies, come up. One thing that I think is really awesome that Patty does is she makes her own stencils. So do you wanna talk for a second about how you do this?
So you wanna open these up, I'll do the pin part.
Okay.
Or you can. Just make sure they're
so these are just, you just bent these.
Yeah, so I like to make my own cutters because then you have it when you need it and it can be any shape you want. It's not something anybody else will have. So I just take a metal, aluminum strips, the same quality as what you buy in a store, and I make the drawing of what I want, and I just take the long strip, and with a needle nose plier, I just bend at every, curve and edge. Like if it's a sharp turn, I always say like whack, and I make it really hard. And if it's a curve, I tend to use my thumb. And honestly, it's really very easy to do, and it's so quick, and it's, I really love it. So
Patty did an Instagram takeover for us where she made lobster cookies, and you handmade the lobster cutter.
I make all my cutters, unless it's something I'm doing so other people can buy a cutter commercially, just because it's easy and you have it when you need it. You don't have to go looking around.
And where do you,
just do it by eye?
No, I have a drawing. Either I find an image online, I print it out and it's a hard edge so I can use it, or if it's a drawing, I do myself. It's nice because every cutter you buy commercially is really a profile so you can recognize it in the store. If you wanted to do something that was like 3/4 or just didn't have a specific outline, you really would have to make it yourself because you're creating the image on there. The outline is not like really, demanding what the image will be. So for today, I'm gonna show you how I made carrot cookies today and decorated them with the natural food coloring. I made this cutter for that. And I usually just tape them together if they're for my own use. And if the tape comes off in the dishwasher or something, I just retape it. But you can even spot weld them or, I don't know, close it up some other way. So the carrot, I use this for the cactus cookies that I did, which we didn't put out yet, but.
Oh, they're right here.
Oh, they're right there, yeah. And the avocado is this one. This I think I took directly from the emoji avocado, actually.
Perfect.
So I'm gonna
Here's
first
some carrots. Carrots?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Since we started with the natural food coloring, I'm gonna show you how I did the carrots with the natural food coloring.
And actually, do you want me to show the difference?
Yes.
So these are with a natural food coloring. You use the turmeric?
No, I use the turmeric for the yellower ones. To make some orange ones, I actually use the natural food coloring that I bought, which is made with amato and, which I didn't have, so I bought this one. And then the the purple one, we use the blueberry freeze-dried. Did you already talk about how we turned this into?
Yes, I did.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, and you can even see.
This is the freeze-dried blueberry that we. Yeah.
Are you able to zoom in on those?
Yeah.
So it's nice to actually see the difference in color.
Like this is the blueberry paste. This is the raspberry paste. And this is the matcha. Then I just took the powder and added water. This is the matcha. And then I just added royal icing to this, or this to royal icing, to make the color. So
these with the lines are with food coloring.
Yeah.
And these without the lines are the all natural dyed icings.
And what's nice about the all natural is they actually have flavor. Like the raspberry
want to get the flavor of the blueberries, the freeze-dried blueberries, in your icing as opposed to just food coloring and sugar.
And plus, carrots are natural, so it kind of works for the carrots because the color suits them.
Yeah.
So I'll show you how I make a cookie. This is a pretty simple one once you've got the shape.
If you want, you guys can feel free to come up and or watch on the TV.
So I need the pin. Sometimes when you make a color, like I made these last night, the royal icing tends to dry out. That's why we have it under a wet towel. So you just want to loosen it up a little. And I'm going to try it out on here. It's still.
Do you want a paper towel?
Yeah. There you go. So I'm just going to outline one. This is the made from the turmeric. So I basically just let the line drop from the tip, and I'm getting all those wiggles in so it'll look kind of natural. My hand isn't just shaking. And you could actually paint the cookie without this line, but it gives, you can get a better shape with the line, but I do it both ways. So that would be the one that I did with the turmeric. This would be the orange one that I used, the commercial orange. I mean the natural. This one's a little runnier.
Do you ever draw on the cookies? Or you always are just kind of free? I've seen people actually draw on the cookie with a pencil.
You've
prior
seen
to
with a pencil? Or
yes.
I don't talk
like
about
a pen. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, I have an edible pen.
Yes.
You can use pencil because it's like non-toxic and kids eat them anyway.
Yeah.
But this is what I will use for the avocado. You can see.
Okay.
In order
right.
to see where I put the lines, I use this. But that's nice.
Yeah.
But for something that already gives you the edge, you don't need to do that.
Right.
So that would be the orange, and then this would be the one we made with the blueberry. And you got the pan there.
Here, I have another carrot for you.
People think you need to let it set for a really long time. You need to let it set for like a minute.
Okay. And that's because of the egg whites.
Well, so that when you brush against it with the icing, it doesn't fall off.
Right.
Yeah, but I've gone right into it. If you're careful, you don't need to let it set long. So this carrot is missing its leaves, but same idea. And like I said, if you don't want to go to the trouble of filling a bag, you don't have to. You could just paint it. I should have showed you this. The other thing is, I only use plastic when I'm doing like a demo, so people can see the color. But normally, my preferred way to do it is parchment paper because it's much more biodegradable, and it seems complicated at first.
And you just make these.
Once you get good at it, I buy the triangles or I cut them. It's something that looks, people have tried trying to learn this, but once you learn it, it's the most fun thing because it's so quick. And you just fiddle with it, get it to a point, and then if you want to use the metal tips, like I have, you can, and just drop them in. But if you actually just wanted to not even bother with a metal tip, you could snip a tiny little hole here. So I like this because it's like so really, you don't need a lot of stuff if you don't want to. I mean, I prefer this to a baggie, but people do put icing in a baggie and just squeeze it. But these are just, I just love holding these. I prefer holding these to plastic. So.
Okay, awesome.
So I'll show you how I fill these in with the natural food coloring. So we have, so we'll start. This turmeric has lightened up a little, but we'll use it anyway. This would be the yellow. No, I guess it's right. This will be the yellow carrot. Right.
Yeah, it does look like a part.
A root, we'll just call them root vegetables.
Yeah.
So I also have a little draw eyedropper somewhere. I think it's right there.
Oh, yeah.
I take the powder that we've already made into a paste, and I add it to royal icing. So we stir it in. But it's too thick to paint with, because I apply my, this is what we use to put the icing in the tube. But now that I'm going to paint with it, I need to thin it out. So can you open this? You can either thin it out with egg white, which I like because it dries a little harder, or you can even just thin it out with water. And I'm still experimenting with natural food coloring, so I'm deciding if I like the water for this or the egg white. But either way, you just stir it up till it gets to a consistency that you want to think you can paint with, which is trial and error, really. So the other thing I do that's a little different is I use a brush instead of like a tube where you see people squeezing it in. I don't know if I like this because I used to be a painter or because I know I like holding a brush. I feel in control.
Yeah.
I don't like pushing the squeezing thing. Also, I always tell people who are helping me, paint to the level of the line. No higher, no lower. And then you get a really thin layer of icing on your cookie, so when you bite into your cookie, you're eating more cookie than icing, and the ratio is just, to me, much more appealing. So I just put a blob of, and this gets really very easy and satisfying to do, just like filling in the lines, kind of mindless and really calming. So yeah, this one's a little lighter than the other because I guess we put a little too much icing in it. If you want it more intense, like that carrot, you would put a little more turmeric paste. So you can see how the line I put on helps you hold it in.
Yep.
And it's not a lot of icing, and there you go. So the same thing with, same thing with the blueberry one. And you can see the spots that are in there. That's and they're dissolving now. The longer you let it sit, the more those little dots will dissolve. But they're really kind of beautiful anyway.
Yeah, they are. Just,
yeah.
Really
yeah.
Fred, it actually makes it look more natural,
exactly.
Like an actual purple carrot would look.
Because it's real. There's no chemicals in here. There's nothing making anything disperse. It's just whatever you do to it. You know, how long you let the paste sit. You know, how long you let this sit. One other thing that sometimes happens with natural food coloring is, you know, if those cookies sit for like a few more days, they'll start to fade a little, get a little spotty, which I personally don't mind, but, you know, if you were selling them to someone who didn't, well, anyone who wants natural food coloring probably is into it, so
right.
You don't have to worry. Anyway, so that's a little thicker than the other, but I still think it's good. So I'm just gonna squeeze the water out of this brush. It's the same brush. And we'll paint this one. So same thing. You don't have to hold the cookie to do this. Sometimes we have a rubber mat here that keeps the cookie from sliding, so you can actually not hold it in your hand.
And with a cookie like this avocado, is this something that you have to wait until the bottom layer dries before you can then?
You know what? I have figured out a way, which I'll show you, just to do this in one step.
Oh, that's amazing.
Otherwise, you'd have to wait a little for this yellow interior color to put that on. But I just figured out this way.
Okay.
Just last night.
Awesome.
So that's, should I paint the third one? Or do you want to?
Or we could move to another. I think it would be fun to see the avocado if you have that ready.
I'll just show you one thing, which is what you do to the once this dries.
Oh, yes.
Or if you could go right into it, and then the color would just sink in a little. which is nice for some things. But I'll just show you on this. So then I'm going to take this line. And you notice I'm holding this like above, letting it fall. People tend to, when they first try it, be right there, which in this case would be okay because a wiggly line might work. But it's actually way easier once you are like not afraid of the icing in the tip to let it fall. You actually, ironically, have more control when you hold this like up. So now I'm just gonna add some of these, you know, little lines to give it that carroty, like carrotiness. And I bet this really, this tastes good because there's a lot of blueberry in here.
Yeah, I'm sure it's delicious.
Yeah. So that's basically it. And then if you wanted to add some, this is it.
This is beautiful, this pin. Beet that you made. I love all the leaf design of the beet.
Yeah, that's natural, that's the natural
that's
stuff
raspberry,
also.
Right? Raspberry.
Raspberry powder.
Yeah, that's the raspberry powder, which took a little while to dry, and then the matcha. I love that so much.
We have the matcha powder.
You could do something here. I like re-outlining it.
That's
I think
amazing,
it makes
right?
things pop mm-hmm. and it's right. a little more 3D. But anyway, yeah, I love this. This is like my new favorite. So
sardines.
Yeah.
Okay, avocado. So we can put the. In case we want to go back.
I don't know if you wanted to show the different stages of an avocado.
Okay, so the avocado is like a slightly another level, like a little more complicated because you're working like a little bit more in the interior. So, and I have a finished avocado somewhere.
Right here.
Well, that's almost finished.
Oh, sorry.
Somewhere, oh, they're down there.
Oh, down there. Okay, awesome. We'll grab those.
So, this is the avocado. So, I have a stencil that I sometimes use, which I don't know where it is, but you can make a stencil for yourself to show you where the lines go, but really you can eyeball this. Oh, I brought the small ones by accident. Okay, these are a little smaller.
They're cute.
Yeah. So I'm just going to take my green, can I have the?
Yeah, the green?
You can start taking the yellow, the dark green. You can start taking the tape off them. I'll take the dark one.
Here's this.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Okay. So I'm going to outline the avocado to get it. This will be the first step to outline the whole avocado. So I'm just going to just eyeball it. You know, looking at my finished one, I don't have to go all the way to the edge of the cookie. I kind of like when cookie shows a little, so you really see it's a cookie.
Which tip is this?
This is a one. I use 0 to 1.5. 1.5 is, if I want to keep the icing really thin, I'll use a one. And they're all these PME brand, which is like the best brand ever because they don't have a seam. So when you're squeezing your icing out, you rarely get a curly line. You're not fighting with the tip. They're great, they're expensive, but they're totally worth it. So then I'm just gonna, you know, line this part.
Oh yeah.
And then because I'm gonna show you how to do this in one sitting, I'm going to line where the seam would go.
Yeah. Do you have any of your cards? Or
so I'm just looking at my other one, but if you wanted to cut out a little circle or use a little circle cutter.
This is my company, Feed Feed.
You know, because you want to.
And I'm Julie. We're a food media company.
You want something to follow.
So,
you can do like what I did here.
This is
card.
He works with me. And what's your name?
I'm here. So you can make your circle first so you're not like worrying about your circle.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to first, this is the one I just did.
So we're a recipe website.
I could go right into
this one. Most of the recipes come from people in our community.
You don't have to let the line.
So they share their recipes on our website, and then we curate the best of those. She's someone in our community that we really love. She's really talented.
Yeah. No, I think delicious.
Her name is Patty Page, and her account is Baked Ideas.
So I'm going to take a small brush, because I want to get all the way into these like tight spaces.
Baked Ideas.
So again, I'm just going to put a blob on my brush and start blobbing in and start pushing it around.
So a question on the actual cooking.
Right.
What's your process for that? For the, before
this
baking?
One is like so I don't want to. I think
I read that all the time.
It's
that
so
you
hard to
cut out the cookie and then freeze it.
What is your community?
Every once in a while, I
our
do it just to see if that really makes a difference.
The world.
I have never found
that
it
share
to make
everything.
I have actually,
photos
and also they say, you know,
cooked or baked. Or they're drinking
the dough before you,
they
I've
publish it on our website and they share it on social media.
And
so we have, you know, content creators, hundreds of thousands
of them. I don't know. I think it's how people handle that stuff.
Oh, we have like we're partnering here with Vitamix.
You know, honestly, I don't
so
know, but I did some cookies at the Barefoot Contessa, and somebody wrote in, the dough was terrible, I had to throw it out, blah, blah, blah. So I went straight to, I thought, this is crazy, did I do something wrong? I went straight to the recipe, made it right then, copied from what was on there, didn't even put it in the refrigerator.
Right.
Perfect.
Right.
So I just think there's, you know, once you got
to
get used to
kitchen.
Yeah. Anyway, okay, so I painted that shell part. I got a little here I'm going to knock, you know, take off. So now we'll use the inside of the avocado. This is, I tend to combine colors to get the colors I need, so this is a touch of leaf green, a touch of yellow, a touch of ivory to dull it down. Because I think getting the right colors, you know, is really helpful. So that looks good. So now I'm going to paint the part that, you know, make it look like this. And we'll just, I'll just go with, well, just for the heck of it, I'll use this one. Again, you get a big dollop on your brush, you kind of blob it around, and then you just start using this edge here.
So how many cookies do you ice in a day when you're doing this?
Depends on the day. Right now we're doing 200.
200 a day.
Yeah. You know, it can be anywhere from baking 1,000 and to baking like 50.
And do you, obviously you need to let the cookie cool before you start icing it. Do you usually bake it the day
before?
Another
myth.
Oh, really? You don't. You just go right for it.
You don't have to. I don't put them on racks. I don't take them off the pans. As long as you can touch it, you can ice it.
Yeah.
There are a lot of things that I think, I don't know why they're out there. You know, unless it's a cookie that's going to bend or be soft, but no. So
how did you get the texture on the finished avocado skin?
I just took the tip that you just saw me use to outline the darker part, and I just made lots of little wiggly lines.
Oh, yeah.
But I have a video of me doing this on my Instagram account.
Her Instagram's amazing. You should check it out.
Okay, so that's that. Now, if I thought I had time to wait and I wanted to make this look like it was sitting on top, I would just paint this all green like I have here and then do the seed or pit, whatever it's called, after. But because I want to show you how you can do it all in one sitting, we'll do it this way. So now you're just going to take the brown-ish. Now that's a little thick, so I'm going to thin it out a little. I'm not going to bother letting this dry. It's not necessary because you've got that line. I'm just going to be a little bit careful. So I'm just going like this to keep it from dripping. Sometimes you don't want to, I have that line that'll keep it from bleeding, but you want to, you know, I wouldn't necessarily do this with black and yellow because then it might bleed, but I don't, in this case, it wouldn't bother me that much if it did, but I don't think it will.
So do you get a lot of interesting requests on your Instagram for specific cookies?
Oh, yeah.
What's the most interesting
That's such a hard question. I have to think for a minute. Interesting, weird, or interesting?
Yeah, food out there. Or like food trends that people have asked you to recreate. I guess avocado toast.
Yeah, well that... Yeah, that was a big one. I just did life-size chicken and waffles, which I just put up today.
Oh, nice.
And life-size New York pizza, which I realized from looking it up is very gross looking. So we had to do that. And then tacos. And it wasn't just painted on like this. Everything was three-dimensional. So the avocado was a cookie.
The radishes on there? I thought we had radishes on there. Did those go on your tacos?
Oh, those slices.
Yeah.
Oh, that was interesting. I did that for KitchenAid. They had an attachment that slices. Rosie. So we did all the vegetables, like the meat and onion slices. Okay. So then what I would do for this is I'll use a dry one. Is this a dry one? Yeah. So then I'm going to... I'll take this. I'm just going to re-outline this. Top part. I'm gonna use the brighter green. Normally I use So I tend to use a lot of detail because it makes things pop. You don't have to go to all these extremes, but I'm just gonna, like when I'm doing a big job, we'll try it all different ways, and then we'll usually come up with the most complicated way is the best, unfortunately. But you can stop at a lot of points before I stop. And now I'll just I'll outline the bottom.
I have the espresso.
Right.
It's made in Italy.
Yep.
That's actually made from a tombstone cutter.
Oh,
it's from my book.
We
turned it into a onesie in my book.
Yeah.
This one's from the book. Yeah, I love this cookie. Because you don't see the key anymore.
Right.
Anyway, so for the texture, you just give it lots of little lines. And in the end, it really gives it that extra avocado-y, you know. Most people would leave it flat, I think, but we like to do this. You have to add a lot, you know, take your time and add a lot of little ones.
Yeah, it's really amazing.
And then...
Can we offer these samples?
Yeah, I think we should. Yeah, we're doing natural dyes. So we use the Vitamix to grind into a powder freeze-dried fruit, which we use to color the icing. Yeah.
We did the cactus and the sade.
That's amazing, right?
And then
here are the samples.
Thank you. These are beautiful. They're too beautiful to eat.
Yeah.
And then
I like the cactus. This just is so real.
Yeah.
For this little like shadow to give it that little, should I keep going?
Yeah.
Oh, I
know.
I need a paper towel. Oh yeah. So sometimes I use a little watercolor, and that's what I'm gonna do to give the this like little lighter shadow. So you just mix a little food coloring with water, and then you have to dab it onto a towel, and then we'll see if this works. Okay, you need a little more color.
Oh, yeah. That'll be nice.
Yeah. It's subtle, but it really adds to it. So I'm just going to go around the edge like that. And you know, all the stuff, it looks like, oh, so much work for a cookie, but you could, you know, not go this far. You could stop sooner and... I don't know, it's kind of worth it because it looks so good.
Yeah.
I need a little white. So I'm going to take a little white to, I'm just going to do it. Like, yeah. Oh, thank you.
We use the Vitamix to grind freeze-dried fruit into a powder to natural. naturally color and flavor the icing so that we don't have to use food coloring. And here are some samples.
We actually could squeeze, if anybody wants to try it, they could squeeze some of
this
the natural
yeah.
onto those
sure,
flavors. Anyway, I'm just
going to
give
the... And there's a
good
surface if you want. You can put them over there and take a good photo. It's up to you. You're welcome to use that surface. Yeah,
I'm
going to
give the seed just a little bit of, the pit, a little bit of shine so that it isn't so flat. So I just put a little white food coloring, I mean white icing, and thinned it out so it's more like a paint. And I'm just giving it a little bit of, you know, three dimension. And then that one's done.
Perfect.
I like it. Every time you make them, the colors are slightly different, something, and so it's kind of fun because it's the same cookie, but it always looks a little different.